Edelle.
In this video, we modify a passive cooler box to be used for camping. We used to take this cooler case with us on family holiday trips when driving by car to France or Italy when I was a kid. The cooler is a case made from aluminium extrusions and metal fittings. It worked quite well, but the usage is visible, especially on the foam inlet, which is honestly quite nasty. If the origins of the case were unknown, I would probably have exchanged the entire inlay. But since this is not the case, we will try to replicate and isolate the interior to make it usable again. All the corners are quite strong and also the wooden panels are in good shape. The replica should be leak-proof and have the same shape and dimensions as the inlay. To create such a shape, we use a technique called vacuum forming, which is common for industry scale parts and fridges. Julius already built a version of a vacuum machine, which we can use, and since he needed to clean out his basement, it was a good opportunity to move the device to our space. A tray, a table or a hollow box with drilled holes in the lid acts as base plate. The air can flow through drilled holes in the base plate and get sucked in by the connected vacuum hose. A thin plastic sheet is clamped tight between two plates, defining the build volume. It is then placed close to a heat source, either from above or below. Once the plastic starts to warp and creates a soft bow shape, it is ready to be used. The attached vacuum is switched on and the hot and soft plastic is then lowered onto the positive and due to the vacuum sucked tight around the foam, recreating the original shape. The excess plastic not related to the part is removed once cooled. In our case, the part is a bit different, since we do not have a foam positive but rather a negative shape. We will try to pull the plastic into the inlay. To realize this, we need to build a new base plate and seal the drilling holes. It is important to seal the inlay airtight to the base plate so the air can only flow through the holes in the bottom of the inlay and suck in the warm plastic, recreating the shape. We used the trash bag and tape to get this done. We used quite a lot, which we could improve in the future to reduce waste. This took a while to prepare and we did some tests turning on the vacuum, checking the seal. The time it takes is well spent, since this will influence the result. To get a flat and even surface, we can place the plastic sheet on. We assembled a makeshift table from spare parts we had in our material section and cut a hole into the table, framing the top of the inlay. As legs, we used some spare legs we had saved from the trash and screwed them to the table surface. The table looks quite funny with these proper legs, but unfortunately they were a bit too long, which is why the base with the attached inlay needed to be raised. The inlay needs to stick through the hole of the table in order for the plastic to create an airtight seal and also because the top of the sidewalls are part of the final shape. For the holes in the inlay, we just used a screwdriver to punch some holes into the styrofoam. The plastic sheet is made from polystyrol, which is industry standard for vacuum molding and also rated as food grade plastic. It comes in large sheets and needs to be cut into smaller pieces to be used with our setup. Polystyrol is quite hard to cut, but once you have the first cut done, it gets easier. Julius created the clamps to fit an exact 50x50cm piece, which means a 1x1.50m sheet can be cut 6 times with no waste. The polystyrol sheet is sandwiched between the clamps, which have marks on each side which fit together. The bottom clamp has bolts sticking out, which fit through drilling holes in the upper frame. Nuts are used to tighten the parts and lock the plastic in its place. A foldable frame is used as housing for the heat source. The frame is covered with tin foil on the inside to reflect the heat and direct it towards the plastic. The clamps with the plastic sheet attached fit exactly on the frame so no heat is lost. This means the heat source in our setup is located at the bottom. The heat source itself is a 450-volt infrared heater. It creates enough heat to warm the plastic to get it soft. The heat source is placed in the housing from below. The warping temperature of the polystyrol sheet we use is about 120 degrees Celsius. The housing is sealed to the floor to keep in the heat. Leaks are also minimized at the top. You can smell the plastic during the heating process, so it is wise to set up some air circulation. The clamped plastic is placed on the frame above the heat source, and a wooden panel is placed on top to speed up the heating process. It takes about 20 minutes for the plastic to create a bowl shape. For the first mold, we left the lid on and heaved the tray on top of the inlay. The forming process only takes a few seconds, and the result of the first try looked promising. The drapery of the plastic layers was minimal, which created a clean edge on the top of the inlay. The inlay shape was recreated perfectly, even the guides for the cooler elements. We noticed the material on the inlay floor was really thin, too thin in fact. It felt and sounded like a plastic bag. To get the plastic off the inlay, Conrad trimmed off the excess plastic. As mentioned earlier, the plastic is quite hard to cut, but with the aid of a heat gun and a cutter, it could be done. The edges of the cut are quite sharp once cooled, which made the next step, pulling out the cast, more difficult. The challenge was here to get enough air between the inlay and the plastic to pop it off. If you hold the inlay against the light source, you can see some trapped styrofoam particles which broke off from the inlay and the distribution of material. At the top it's quite dark and at the bottom the light shines through. This means the plastic has difficulties reaching the bottom of the inlay before cooling down. The cooling starts immediately when removing the heat source and increases for every surface area it touches. To improve even heating of the sheet, for the next try, we flipped the sandwich a few times 180 degrees during heating. We experienced some issues with the distribution of the plastic material and therefore tried to melt the plastic on the sides of the frame with a heat gun and to pull the softened plastic towards the center with some PET bottles. We also tried to install some wooden guides below the frame with the goal to get the dimensions of the warped plastic to a similar size as the inlay. The plastic sometimes stuck to the guides and we lost some parts on the way, but this method seems to improve the result. Removing the lid from the frame enabled us to use the bottles to push the soft plastic in the inlay, which helped distribute the material more evenly. We molded 5 inlays in total with different results. This shows how difficult it is to replicate the same shape each time. It may be due to our setup or because of parameters which change during each pull. We try to do the steps similar each time while still improving the outcome, but the temperature, for example, could have been different since we worked on the project on different days. The gaps on the clamped plastic are because of the bottle push method. Once the plastic is soft, the tension from the bowls is reduced, but this is not an issue since the usable area is not affected. It does, however, create a leak for the heat, which might cause an uneven distribution of the temperature. In the offcut of the excess plastic though, you can see the material thickness is also visible when backlit. The next version of the inlays improved, the material distributions and especially the bottom was becoming more solid. The corners were still the most problematic zone. It is interesting how different the inlays turned out. In sum, the bottle marks were visible on the base. One had ripped and showed a hole, and one inlay had a vertical wall created in the middle for unknown reasons. In one inlay, there were bubbles visible, with different amounts of stretch marks. Drapery in general happened a lot. This is a pity, since the material could have been used in the inside of the inlay. But since it did not have enough time or force or even space, it did not make it inside the inlay, so it piled up on the table surface. Due to shrinkage, the edge and the inlay were also behaving weirdly.
Interesting to see was that the styrofoam material from the inlay was affected by the heat of the plastic, which caused it to deform as well.
There already was an usable version for the inlay, but to visualize the flow of the material and its distribution across the inlay, we decided to mold another version with a grid drawn onto it. Each square is the exact same size and the deformation is already visible during the heating process. It increases with the heat gun and bottle push method. Pulling the material inside the inlay cavity worked quite well, so it is possible to form a negative shape. But if we get back to this project, I would like to try creating a form positive of the inlay and see if this improves the results. If any of you guys has some more knowledge in this regard, we are happy to get some feedback in the comments.
Again, the corners were the problematic zone. This is also the most important region of the inlay, since it is the base of the cooler case, and should hold spilled or condensated liquid, as well as the weight from the refrigerated produce.
Some of the squares are stretched several times their original size, making the material thin again.
With the form positive, the inlay would be created upside down or 180 degrees rotated to our method, which means the corners get created first due to the plastic reaching this region first. The material should therefore be much more solid and much stronger here.
Now with the inlay finished, the only thing left is to renew the inside of the lid.
Here I just removed the old styrofoam parts, which were once glued together and then glued to the inside of the lid. The black foam had had its days and almost crumbled to the touch. I put it in a trash bag to prevent contaminating our entire space and used a vacuum to clean out the case.
I traced the shape of the old inlet onto a block of new styrofoam and cut it into shape with a hot knife. After a few adjustments, the new insulation slid perfectly into the lid. When comparing the before and after, the improvement is highly visible and the inside of the cooler case looks clean and white again. The edges of the molded inlay could be improved, but for the upcoming camping trip, this will work fine. The case fits perfectly behind the passenger seat and can even be accessed from here. If you liked the video, consider subscribing to our channel or leave some feedback below. You can also check out this video. Or if it's your birthday, maybe this one. Here, Dalle.